Hello everyone, Rickard from MI6 Sweden here once again. Today I'm going to talk to you about some guns. Some of James Bond's guns through the movies. I will not talk about all of the guns, but I will talk about some of them that I have collected. And I hope that you will enjoy, like and subscribe to my videos. I have a lot of videos out on YouTube right now, and I hope that you will like them. This is part of my collection. I will do a bit of filming like this. So you get a feel for it. Okay. Let's talk about some guns. In the first movie, Dr. No, we see that James Bond arrives in M's office early in the morning. And he is ordered to take his jacket off and give M his gun. And the gun that he gives M in the movie is this Beretta. This is different Beretta than the one Fleming described in his novel. The one that Fleming described in the model was a much smaller version, and the smaller one, and it didn't have these handles. It was a skeleton grip, as it was called, where you can see the magazine and the bullets. But this is the Beretta that Bond gives to M. You can clearly see it in some of the shots in the movie. And it's a nice handgun, really nice handgun. The reason why M doesn't want Bond to have this one anymore is that he has had his silencer on and got caught with it in his belt or in his shoulder holster. And that almost got him killed in From Russia with Love, in the book From Russia with Love. In the movie, M just mentions that it almost got Bond killed on his last assignment. Q, as Major Boothroy, as he is called in the after credits, is not played by the same actor as in the other movies, but in this movie, he comes in and gives Bond his new gun. This Walther PPK, or it should be have been the Walther PPK. They had problems getting the new Walther PPK from Walther, and they also had troubles fitting a silencer and so on. So they gave Bond, in the movie, they give Bond this Walther PP. As you can see, if I lay them beside each other, you can see clearly that the PP has a longer barrel. This is the gun, but they say that it is Walther PPK. And as you know, the Walther PPK is the official Bond gun and has been through all of the Bond movies, I would say. In the next movie, I have some things also. I have Red Grant's gun. This one. This one is rather nice. It's a sturdy gun. And I think that in the movie, Grant has an extension here. A shoulder grip. And uses it as a machine gun. And also from that movie, this flare gun that plays a good part in the movie. I wish that I had the gun from Diamonds of Forever, but I don't. So we will go over to Roger Moore's guns. And when we talk about Roger, we can start with the first Roger movie, Live and Let Die, where he wears this, and the pipe gets crushed by Teehee. And the thing was that he wasn't supposed to carry a Walther in the Live and Let Die film, because they didn't want him to be compared by Connery. That's why he doesn't wear a tux in that movie also. And he doesn't say Bond, James Bond, like Connery did. But he, in some scenes, he wears the Walther. I think it's two scenes. It's the scene when he meets Solitaire, and it's the scene when he takes the gun to Mrs. Bond's head, Rosa Carver's head, and tells her that she has to make a choice. The gun we remember from that movie is this one, I think. The Magnum, or the Colt. This is a 357. And it's almost exactly like the one Bond has in the movie. This is with a long barrel also. And this one he shoots at the funeral site with. Shoots the bad guy with this one. And some people say that he used this gun because it was a very popular gun at the time, because an American named Clint Eastwood would have worn it in Dirty Harry, and the Dirty Harry movies was quite a big thing in the beginning of the 70s. And now Bond also carried the most powerful handgun in the world. Let's go on to The Man with the Golden Gun. I won't show you the Golden Gun because I have had that in 3 or 4 of my YouTube videos already. So I will show you this one instead. It's Knickknack's gun. Do you remember? Oh, a gun with a peanut. And this is the Knick-Knack gun. He eats peanuts and threatens Bond with a small derringer. 1983. We have two movies in 1983, as you know, Octopussy and Never Say Never Again. And in both of those movies, Bond uses this. This isn't a Walther PPK, as you can see. It's the P5. It was the more modern gun. That's the PPK and that's the P5. Bond tells Q that he has misplaced his PPK, and I believe that's when he gets this one instead, the P5. This is 9mm, and it's a larger gun, and this was also the gun that Sean Connery is seen using in Never Say Never Again. We have quite a bit of a pile here. Okay, let's go on. Let's go into the Dalton movies. I have one thing from the Dalton movies. And it's this. The Walther VA-2000. Assault rifle or sniper rifle. I have made this myself because they are very, very, very expensive to buy. And I think that it's quite nice. It looks the part and has a big place in my collection. So this is the gun that he shoots the sniper, or should I say Kara, with in the beginning of the movie. Also Dalton, and this is not Bond's gun. This is Sanchez Mini Uzi that he uses in the movie. Quite a few times. This is also quite a nice gun. Really like these replicas that you can have. And then we come to Pierce Brosnan. And the first gun you see in Pierce Brosnan's hand, or rather the stuntman's hand, is this one. It's a grapple hook gun with the laser. It's from the beginning of GoldenEye. It's always also quite nice. It's a replica, of course, but it's a nice gun. Also in GoldenEye, you can see General Ormov use this gun. It's the Makarov, and it is the size of a PPK. I can show you by laying them beside each other, like that. You see that they are almost the same. And he is using that to kill Alec Trevelyan, or Bond thinks that he kills Alec Trevelyan with this gun. And then in Tomorrow Never Dies, you can see Bond changes from his Walther PPK to the more modern Walther P99. This is from Vicky. This is toy gun. I have replica guns also, but I took this because it was nearest. And this is the Walther P99, and then he uses that one, that gun, through all his movies to Die Another Day. And in Die Another Day, we also see Bond uses a revolver. I know that he uses a Colt revolver, but it was supposed to be a Webley. If you read read the vaccine material, but they couldn't find a Webley. They wanted a British gun, and they also wanted a Webley because this gun is often used by Fleming in the novels. And in the movie, you can see Bond takes a book, Birds of the West Indies by James Bond, a nod to Fleming. He takes a revolver, also a nod to Fleming, and a binocular. So this is that. Well, I think that was all of the guns for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. I will be back for some more specials. And if you wonder why I didn't talk about Daniel Craig, you know that Daniel Craig uses a P99 in the Casino Royale. In the beginning of Casino Royale, he uses a P99. And then he returns to the Walther PPK for all of his tenure. So that is why I haven't gotten any of his guns. He also uses a Glock, or weapons that he takes from the bad guys, but that's not interesting, I think. So I hope that you have enjoyed my video, and until next time, thanks for now. This is Rickard from MI6 Sweden signing off.